Dear students, today we learn about extremist phase, and in the last video we learn about moderate phase and the leaders of moderate phase: Gopal Krishna Gokhale, Firoz Shah Mehta, and Surendranath Banerjee. These all were the moderate leaders. Now here, all Indians leaders who were politically aware kept aside their differences of caste, religion, language, province, and gathered on a single platform of Indian National Congress. In this period, means when this Indian National Congress was founded in the year, or established in the year 1885, all the politically aware people, they came under a single platform of Indian National Congress and unanimous means in complete agreements, means all the political leaders, they were agree with the Indian National Congress and regarding the objectives of the Congress, and they were taking forward the movement of constitutional means. Here in the first video we learn about moderate phase, and these leaders, they have a hope if we demand through constitutional method, then the British will give us justice. But this extremist leaders, they were against them here, but there were differences regarding the working system. Means in the moderate phase, they believed with the peaceful way or constitutional way, but these extremist phase leaders, they were against to the moderate phase leaders. These were ideological differences. From these differences, two main political groups were formed: the moderate, who advocate peaceful and constitutional manner, and the extremist, who believed in savor. Savor means strict struggle for attainment of freedom. Means because of the differences in the ideology or in the opinion, there were the two groups in Indian National Congress. One is the moderate, they believed in peaceful and constitutional manner or peaceful and constitutional way for the justice from the British government, and the another, that is extremists, means this group, they doesn't like the policy of the moderate leaders, that we should keep a hope on the constitutional or peaceful way. They were against it, and they believed in the strict struggle, means we should forcefully struggle for the attainment of freedom. And in it, Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, and Bipin Chandra Pal were believed to the extremist leaders. Means here we learn there were the two groups in the Indian National Congress. One is extremist and one is moderate. And in the extremist leaders, they believed on the severe, means on the strict or fighting way. We can say they believed that we should fight, we should strictly struggle with the British government, then only we will be able to get the freedom. And in it, Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, and Bipin Chandra Pal, these were the extremist leaders, and moderate leader Gopal Krishna Gokhale, Firoz Shah Mehta, and Surendranath Banerjee, these three were the moderate leaders. In the early period, the extremist leaders, for bringing political awakening among the Indians, used a method like newspaper, national festivals, and national education. They newspaper like Kesari and Maratha were the newspaper through which Lokmanya Tilak made strict criticism or severe criticism on the suppressive policy of the British. Here, to create an awareness among the people, these extremist leaders, they used newspaper, national festivals, and national education. And in it, this Kesari and Maratha were the main newspaper in Marathi language. through which Lokmanya Tilak made severe criticism on the suppressive policy. Means suppressive means the Britishers, they are trying to make Indians fool, or just they needs to earn the more profit by trading or by imposing the high tax on the Indian goods. Suppressive policy means they were against the Indians and they needs to earn the more profit by trading in India. Of the British in Bengal province, Amrit Bazar Patrika was a mouthpiece of extremist ideology. Here Amrit Bazar Patrika, it was in Bengal region and it was the newspaper through which the extremist leaders, they were trying to aware the people about the policy of Britishers, about the suppressive policy of Britishers. By forgetting the internal differences, people should come together and exchange their ideas. Common people should get inspiration from contribution of national personalities. And here it was their another ideology that we should, or Indians should, forget their internal differences on the basis of caste, creed, and they exchange their ideas. Common people should get inspiration and they should give their contribution of national, they should give their contribution in the freedom struggle. With these objectives, Tilak started organizing of Shiv Jayanti and Ganesh Utsav. And in that period, the way of British, it was suppressive, means they never allowed to the Indians to gather for the political purpose. So this was the new way used by Lokmanya Tilak. They started organizing Shiv Jayanti and Ganesh Utsav on the large scale to gather the people, because for political reason, if people came together, then the government will ban them. But for religious reason, if people came together, the government will not ban them, was his opinion. It was the opinion of Lokmanya Tilak that if we are going to gather the people for political way, the government will ban on them. So better to make them to came them to come together for the religious, for the religious reason, then the government will not ban, and then we can share our ideas, thoughts with one another, and it will be helpful for Indian freedom movement. In the Mandale prison means jail, when in the Mandale prison, Tilak wrote Gita Rahasya. Here we learn in the jail of Mandale, Lokmanya Tilak, they wrote Gita Rahasya. Its core was philosophy of Karma Yoga and stressed that people should always be in action. The extremist leader established education institutions for creating a generation concerned about own language and tradition. The extremist leaders were of the opinion that if lakhs of people take part in the freedom movement and challenge the British government by struggling against them, only then the success will be achieved. It was the way of fighting of the extremist people. If the lakhs of people take part in the freedom movement and they challenge to the British government, and by struggling against the British government at a time, then only we will be able to get a success. The success will be achieved if we are going to come together in the large quantity.